Welcome back to the Dubai Air Show. There are over 100 airplanes with many manufacturers on display. So today, we're gonna check out some of the most modern airplanes come from Russia, the Mc21 and the Sukhoi SuperJets. Let's find out. I'm visiting another new airplane at the show, the Russian Mc21. I'm very keen to find out what's inside like. Morning, dobrye utro.
Dobre utro.
Yeah, I'm excited to see a brand new Russian aircraft, Mc21.
The main competitive advantages of our aircraft are high aspect ratio composite wing. We use new composite materials. Composite wing and new materials for our wing. By increasing the aspect ratio, we reduce the induced drag and fuel consumption of the aircraft. Also, we use new systems. We have the widest fuselage in the class of single aisle aircraft. And here in this fuselage, you just can see a portion of a passenger cabin. We put it here just for demonstration purposes. So we have two rows of business class seats and three rows of economy class seats.
Let me try to sit here and sit down. And it's an interesting airplane because it's a green airplane in the front that has testing station and terminals. And then in the back, there's a cabin demonstration. It's a hybrid kind of model. How many seats if it all filled, Elena?
Well, in the case of a two-class configuration, it will hold 163 seats, with 16 seats of business class and 147 of economy class.
Okay.
The maximum capacity of the aircraft is 211 passengers.
So you're directly competing with Airbus 320.
Absolutely.
And the Boeing 737,
Narrow
body. It feels quite wide because you don't have a lot of seats right now inside the plane. Well, and it feels very modern, I have to say, give you credit. Huh? And very big window as well.
Yeah.
Very big window. Yeah, very big. Much bigger. It's good for me, plane spotter. When do you expect the certification to complete and the plane enter service to fly?
So we estimate that the Russian certificate will be issued by the end of this year, and the first aircraft will be delivered to our first customer by the end of next year.
Which airline will be the first airline to fly the Mc21?
Well, it will be Rossiya, Russian airline.
Rossiya, Russian airline.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. When this plane enters service, I have to give it a try. Let's check out the Mc21 cockpit here. Whoa, I'm surprised. A narrow body airplane. The cockpit here is huge, actually. Very interesting. It looks so familiar. Four major display screen. It looks very similar to the Western airplane now. You know, even the color has changed. We used to have the green color, the emerald green, J color. Everything looks very modernized. And yoke as well, fly by wire. Out of all the features on board, what's the one killer feature you have, the advantage Mc21 has?
My personal opinion, I'm a design engineer, so I think that the high aspect ratio of the wing is the most important feature of our aircraft because it reduces drag.
After seeing one Russian airplane, Mc21, this is another one. I remember this one, a SuperJet, but I think this is a VIP one. I'm keen to find out what a Russian luxury airplane looks like. Let's go.
have to open a door ourselves to check it out. This is like open sesame. Oh, okay, let's come on in.
Wow, this is very different to the airliners.
Wow,
this is quite some luxury.
It's actually very nice, the interior, you know, the fitting, the design, everything blends in very well. When you walk in, it gives you a very welcome feeling, actually.
This is where in the second zone, right? The first one, you've got a meeting, and this is a lounging zone. And so they just told me everything can be controlled on one touch of the finger on the tablets. The table can go up and down. And then you can watch your favorite entertainment, the map, the camera. Imagine dining here and watching your favorite show flying at 39,000 feet. That's some high life. So towards the end of the plane, this is where the bedroom. Of course, a bigger airplane, you can have a double-sized bed and a lounge. Yeah, I think the standard of the luxury is getting higher and higher. When you have a space like this airplane, even I can see there are electric blinds as well. Yeah, beautiful ambience, isn't it? So everything's on tablet now, so it's here. Wow. You have to do here. Oh, this is dim and dark. Wow. So advanced, actually. We're checking out the bathroom. Wow, surprise. There's actually also a shower in this SuperJet. Yeah, very interesting. And didn't realize a SuperJet felt it was quite small. The inside, there's actually lots of leg room, yeah. Very nice, very surprising. Ah, you can move around, okay. So, I didn't know what the brand Aurus. You know, is it a charter operator, airline? What's Aurus?
Aurus is a newly emerged Russian brand of high technology products in the premier segment. And we agreed with the Aurus to collaborate and have their name on our board to present to the world's market the finest severely upgraded piece of equipment in the private jet segment. Aurus is a combination of part of the two words, aurum, which means gold in Latin, and RUS, which is a part of Russia.
It was not something I have expected. Your deck out is similar to all your peers in the industry. We'll see ACJ, BBJ. What's your biggest advantage on this plane? You think you have the edge over them?
Our price tag is significantly lower than those.
You have significant lower price tag?
That's correct.
What's the fuel consumption on the SSJ?
Very economically effective piece of equipment. 1.8 tons of fuel per flight hour.
1.8 ton per engine per hour.
No, not per engine, for the entire aircraft.
Really?
Yes.
Only 1.8 ton per hour?
That's correct.
Wow. This is one of those severely upgraded feature he told me. I put my phone here and there's a wireless charger. Yeah, it's now charging. Nice, get rid of all the wires, no more cables.
How long and the distance of the range Sukhoi can fly?
Максимальная дистанция, которую может пролететь этот самолет, 7300 километров. Время полета займет порядка 8-9 часов.
And also, what is the speed and also how high it can fly?
Максимальная высота полета эшелон 400, 40 тысяч футов. И средняя скорость в экономичном режиме 850 км в час.
Like Airbus, right? You have table here?
No.
Table? Really? Wow. nice ergonomic design.
Yeah. Navigation display and system display. Electrical system, hydraulic system, air condition system, engine APU, fuel, doors.
So I toured the whole plane, but I found one secretive compartment here. Is this actually the crew rest?
No. It's deployable air stairs.
A deployable air stairs. Yes. So your air stair, you don't need this stair. You can have go to remote airfield. They have no infrastructure. There's a stair will come down.
Yes. True.
That's very unique for a private jet to have a deployable air stairs. Wow, these planes are really modern, not the classic Tupolev or the Illusion that I used to fly. And I really wish them success because the sky needs more variety. Hopefully we get to fly them soon.